Thank you all very much for coming to attend our demonstration. I am moved deeply. Let me show you a technique, shihonage. I'll move back. It's done this way. This is the way it's usually executed. We don't do shihonage this way. In this present world of fighting arts, this way would not be taken seriously. Not at all. The outcome is already determined at the moment of contact. This is the way we do shihonage. This is how we enter. From there, we enter directly. We don't do it this way. Here, like this, this is how we enter and complete the technique. We should be able to cut at any time, but you can't cut your opponent from the inside. You follow the path of the sword. The Japanese sword is different from the Western sword. You should be able to deal with an opponent without hurting him or yourself. We did this before. This is the irimi I did before. From here we enter and do it like this. This is how we do it. Then we enter here. In this case, the hand is already raised and we enter here. Since we can't actually strike, we enter this way. We enter this way and do irimi. The outcome is already determined when he has raised his hand. Since we can't really strike, we enter this way. We enter this way. It's already decided. With the sword, we enter and strike like this. He strikes in this way, and we have already entered. When he has raised his sword, the outcome has already been decided. Whether we are using the Ken or the Jo, there are many possibilities for executing effective martial techniques. You must be able to do techniques this way. All of Aikido techniques are like that. In this situation, I do this and then enter. Actually, the opponent's jaw would be crushed. But since we can't practice that way, we invite him to strike and enter. This is how we do it. At the first, second, or third stage of the movement, the outcome is already decided. We can throw our opponent instantly at any stage. This technique, too, is practiced by everyone, Nikkyo. Naturally, the Nikkyo includes several different elements. You can do Nikkyo whether you're using a Ken or a Jo. It's the same movement. The movement is the same when you're using a jo. You turn in the same way, then enter. You turn your partner all the way, and then enter here. This is the technique. It's the same whether you're using the Ken or Joe. Now, if I do it with the Ken, it's like this. Then I enter. In reality, the outcome is decided at the moment of contact. However, since we can't practice that way, I enter this way and stop. You do this and then parry your opponent. The outcome is absolutely decided at that point. Then you can strike a second, third, fourth, or fifth time. We do the technique entering this way. In reality, we could deal five lethal strikes. But in Aikido, we give the opponent a chance to reflect on his actions. Also, you shouldn't clash. There was no sound, was there? If you clash, it's no longer Aikido. You win in an instant. You shouldn't stop your opponent. That's wrong. You receive your partner's attack properly and properly draw him out. This is the correct way to do Aikido. The old style martial arts were for the purpose of subduing the enemy. That is not the purpose of Aikido. You invite the opponent to grab and then draw him out. This is the purpose of Aikido. It's done like this with the Joe. We enter, and then enter again. This is how we did it, then this movement, and we come here. In reality, you would strike immediately, and it would be instantly over. However, we can't practice that way, so we modify the technique this way. We all do this kind of daily training in our dojo. Let's do this from Aihami. These were Ikkyo and then Irimi. In these techniques, usually people try to push back the opponent's arm towards his head. We don't do it that way. We move in this way. We draw the opponent out this way. By taking a half step here, we can execute a thrust. You enter like this. We control the opponent in this movement. But in Aikido, we say that control is 70% of the technique and throwing 30%. What do we mean by control? One of the basic principles of Aikido is to allow the opponent to move as he wants. This is a basic principle. Not allowing the opponent to do what he wanted was the way of the old martial arts. In Aikido, we let the opponent do as he wishes, and therefore we must apply this principle when controlling him. Throws in Judo are not done that way. You throw your opponent down in front of you. In Aikido, the outcome is decided in an instant. When the opponent acknowledges the error of his ways, we release him. This is how we throw an Aikido. Aikido is completely different in this respect. That split second includes atemi and everything else. Also, in Aikido, we use atemi strikes. All of the techniques to control the opponent use strikes. In the Ikkyo I just showed, As I said before, you use the atemi here. Then from here, you can enter to throw. Here you use atemi. Then you can throw. We use atemi strikes. Come over here. Using the can, you can enter from here. It's very simple. You just enter. I think the audience can see better from here. I'll show the movement using the jo. It's like this. This is ikkyo. Then you enter, then withdraw, and then enter. Now we're looking at ikkyo. It's like this. You can execute a thrust from here. Since we can't actually do this, in reality, we don't make contact. Also, in the case of the irimi we saw earlier, just a moment. Shall I tuck the cord in? I can't seem to get the hang of using this thing. This is the position we move from in this technique. Then we enter this way. At the moment of contact, the outcome is already decided. We control the opponent this way. This is the distance appropriate for using the ken. You must understand the proper distance or moai. The sword is not used for hitting, but rather for cutting. This is how the sword is used. You use the end to strike when using the jo, but for the sword, you use the cutting edge. You must understand the proper distance appropriate to the situation. Karate and boxing are fast. If you take a step back, you will be struck. You shouldn't fight according to your opponent's tactics. The way we do it, for example, when he comes with a punch, he can't enter. If you parry like in modern karate or kendo, there's a problem. Our way of doing it is to enter. In reality, you take a half step to control your opponent. You control him in an instant. From that distance, you can gain control of your opponent. Okay. This technique is Sankyo. These are all the same. He strikes, we enter here. This is how you would do it in reality. This is how you would enter. I should pull the cord out. I'm just not up to using this thing. So at this stage, we enter. As I said before, you enter this way when a punch comes. He is completely blocked. we do it this way, and enter like this. From Ihami. Then we enter here. So we use exactly the same movement. And enter. I enter, withdraw, and counter strike. Using the Zhou, it is exactly the same. You enter, then the outcome is decided. The movement is exactly the same. You're in a position to strike at any time. You can do virtually any technique, whether using the Ken or Zhou. The same is true for the Sankyo movement. In the case of Sankyo, when he raises his hand, I have already entered. So when a punch comes, I have already entered. This is how I enter. At this point, I can execute a throw. When throwing, I execute an atemi. I do an atemi at each stage, then I throw. If you execute this move, you can throw according to the flow of the ken. The movement is the same as using a ken. You follow the flow. If he comes like this, I enter and then cut. You can do many applications using both the ken or the zhou. In the case of a yokomen strike, we do it this way. Most places do it in this way. They block with one hand and counter strike with the other. We don't do it this way. The outcome must be decided before receiving the strike. So the direction we use is different. So you move this way or this way, and then enter here. You move here and enter. There are some circumstances when we enter. For example, for Gokyo we enter. But this is not right because the punch is waiting. There are times when you have to strike in order to enter. At those times, you enter this way. You must enter like this. Or like this. You have to be able to throw your opponent at any time before touching him. There is no clashing at all in our Aikido. This is somewhat of a broad outline of our Aikido. Please allow me another 3 minutes. For example, if we are to defeat someone who is wielding a sword, we cannot ignore it. In our regular training, we would apply the first kata like this. This includes kaiten nage. that movement is included. In our first and second kata, this is included. This form includes kaiten nage. In the case of shihonage, this is the shihonage. In these two, the Shihonage movement is included. Then this includes Nikyo, which is included in the hand movements. This is the Nikyo movement. Next, the Sankyo includes a thrusting movement. We enter from here, then the thrust, then enter. This is part of the Sankyo. Then this is the Yonkyo, which includes a finishing movement. There are about 12 other movements, but we've run out of time. I'd like to cover them the next time. I'm sorry I've jumped around a lot and taken too much time. Next on will be Morihiro Saito Shihan, whom we have the most respect for. He served O-sensei until the end of the founder's life. Please stay until the end and watch Saito Sensei's demonstration as he brings to us O-sensei's techniques. Thank you very much.